Hello, legends and super legends. Welcome to Veloharmony. Eldred here. Today I'm making a video about walking you guys through what I carry when I go riding in my patch kit. First of all, I want to start with, some of you may have noticed in my earlier videos that I was trying this bag. This is made by Arundel, the Arundel bag. It's okay, but for me, what I found is over time, even though this bag mounts with one strap and there's nothing on the seat post, it sits under the saddle. My leg, on the back of my leg, I still touch this bag, and over time, it was rubbing on my shorts. So it just wasn't worth having. I mean, there's nothing on here other than, if you can see, just this little ridge, and it's canvas, but it's hard. And for some reason, that still rubs your Lycra. And so I need a bag that will, let me turn the camera here and show you guys. I need a bag that will sit like this here on the back of the saddle, not down here to where my legs would touch it, but back in this quadrant. And I know they have little bags. I've got a small one here that holds one tube. But for me, I just stick it in my pocket and it definitely fits right back here. But that works for me. Something like this. I don't know if you guys can kind of see it. That's out of the way. It's not hanging over here or anything because my leg hits back here. And over time, this will wear your shorts. And our shorts cost too much for these cheap little bags to wear them out. So needless to say, I'm not carrying a bag. I stick this in my jersey. I have this pouch. But what my focus on today is about to show you what I carry in my bag when I go riding. Let me adjust this thing back the way I had it. So what I consider to be essentials for your patch kit, whether you have a saddle bag on there, because some people have too much stuff that they carry. There is no reason to carry the kitchen sink when you're going on a ride, because the assumption is you've kept your bike maintained somewhat, that you don't need your whole tool kit with you. Some people get a little crazy, and I will show you in a little bit. So, my tool kit, I'm going to bring it close to the camera so you can see. I have my trusty little pump, the Topeak Pocket Rocket. I'll put the link down here where you can go to my site. There's a link there if you're interested in buying it. These are the best little pumps. They pump up within 20 to 30 seconds. You got a hard tire. You're ready to go. Proven. I like them so much. I got two of them. I got one in carbon and one in, this is the aluminum one. And I just got them because the carbon went on sale, because otherwise I would have just bought two aluminums. Now, I have a pump in my bag. This bag I got from SF Bags. I've talked about it in another video. I will put the link on there as well. You can use that same link and go to my blog page, and all the recommended cycling products will be there. Because people have mentioned that when I talk about things, they want to see the link. And it's a lot easier for me to have a page on my blog with all the recommended products in different sections than to put links in all these videos. It just gets to be too much. So I can just put the link to my page for the recommended cycling products. You go there and you can just find everything. And the links will be specific to what I'm talking about. So it just won't be to the general page. Now, your pump, my pump, and I have one tube. Oops. I have one tube with a tire iron. I have one tire iron on here. Park sells, this is a Park Tool tire iron. They've got all kinds of brands out there. This comes in a set of three. I carry one because with a foldable tire, that's all you need. And that's another thing. For the tires that you buy, maybe I need to make a different video, but I'm just going to mention it here. Avoid buying wire bead tires. They are a royal pain to get off the rim. Okay? Sometimes you need 2 to 3 tire levers to get them off. They're just, it's not worth the few dollars you save. They're a little less expensive. But you want to go with foldable tires. Doesn't matter what quality of tire. Make sure it's foldable. It's a lot easier to mess with. I will do another video about how to do your repairs on the road, because I have some things to point out to you guys. That will be in a different video. So a tube, you want your tire iron. You don't want to forget that. There are ways you can remove a tire without a tire iron, but that's a different video. But you want a tire iron. It's a lot easier. Now, that's your essential. One tube. When I'm going further, if I'm going like 3 hours away from home, I take another tube, or I take this little bag. It has a tube in there as well, and I just stick it in one of my pockets. So even though I have this, I'll take a second tube, especially if I'm riding alone. But It's not absolutely necessary. It's just an extra safety measure. And the reason why you don't have to have that is because if you have a patch kit with you, then you're set, because it's not very often that you'll have multiple flats. So let me go in here. I carry, along with the tube, a multi-tool. Now, this is a bit much. This is a Lezine. It's very flat, so I have that in there. And I will put the link on my site as well for you, for those of you who want it. It's a Lezine multi-tool. At a minimum, really what I find that I use the most is a 4 millimeter socket wrench. Let me get a small one here. One of these, I usually stick these in my my pocket. A lot of times after I've put on a new cleat on a shoe and I'm going for the first ride on the road, I always stick one of these in there just in case my cleat's binding and pulling on me in some way. I have this to just kind of loosen things up a little bit to get them set. At a minimum, this is what you need. This is what I use the most, and it's mostly to mess with my cleats if they come loose, because they can come loose after over time if you haven't kept up with it. But for the most part, if you're keeping your bike maintained, you don't have to have a tool. The multi-tool is nice to have as extra insurance. And there are many different kinds of multi-tools. I'll show you another one that I have that I keep in this pouch. It's another pouch that I use. I got this from a local shop. It's an old school multi-tool that has like a 4, 5, 6 millimeter. I mean, it's got the basic stuff that you would need. And other than the 4, I haven't really had a need to use anything else. But this is nice to have. And I'll have to find out if there's a link. I'll look online when I'm doing the production to see if I can get you guys. This is also made by Park Tool. And I got this from a local bike shop, West End Bicycles, here a long time ago. But it's really nice to have. It's got a straight edge on there, like a screwdriver, a flathead screwdriver. And it's got the 4, 5, and 6 millimeter. I think it's 3, 4, 5, and 6, or 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. It's got a bunch. And it's got a little bitty one, looks like a 2.5. And this comes in handy when you're doing things that require the little bitty, like the 3 millimeter head and so forth. So it's very, very handy to have. Let me put that on the side. So, and I will do a summary when I'm done. I carry these nitrile gloves because if I'm repairing my tire on the road, you guys know it, your hands get dirty. So I wear these, okay? And they're just cheap insurance. They don't weigh anything. I fold them up and I put them in there. It's just nice to have. It's a good idea to keep your hands clean, because a lot of times after you do repair, sometimes even removing your wheel from the bike, you get dirt in your hands. Let's see. Now, this bag happens to have a pouch. Whatever bag you're using, you want to at least have some form of identification. And so what I usually have is an old driver's license, because the fact that it's expired does not change who I am or where I live. So I have an old driver's license in here that I don't use in my car anymore, because my information on here is the same. It's in here. And in this pouch, I have some loose dollar bills. You want to have at least like a $20 bill or something like that just to have in there. A lot of people just fold it and put it in with the patch kit. I've got some bills in here that I can buy Gatorade or stuff like. I carry the small bills and usually like a quarter, because a lot of the places will have these sales and I don't like to carry a lot of change. So it ends up, most of the places I go, it's like $3.25 for 2 Gatorade, because they have them like 2 for $3, and once you pay taxes, it's like $3.25. So I have a quarter, and then I use 3 large bills and pay them. I don't want any change in here. But even if you do have change, it's not that bad. In here, I also have a key to my home in the bag. And then I have a boot where I took an old tire and I cut a little piece. That's an old tire. Cut a little piece to have a boot. Now, I've had these in here for more than a year. I've never had to use it. It's nice to have and not need it. But when you need it, you don't want to be without it. So that's a nice little pouch. Some people put their stuff in just a plastic bag, like a sandwich bag or a Ziploc bag. That would work too. What I'm more focusing on is not what you carry it in, but what's in there. So you want a pump, or if you're using canister, you want your canister and your tool to get the air into the tire if you're using canisters, or your pump. And you want minimum, of course, 1 tube. 2's better if you can fit it in there. But really, one is good enough, especially if you have one of these patch kits like I have here. Let me show you. They're glueless patch kits, and they're really good to have. Okay, the patch kit I carry, I wanted to show you guys. I keep them in this wallet with my money and my ID. And you see how flat it is. I got it in a small plastic bag. They don't come from the manufacturer like that, so I'm going to show you how they come from the manufacturer. It's just easier to carry when they're nice and flat versus when they come in this little plastic box. So Park 2 makes them. You can get them anywhere, Amazon. I'll put a link on my site for this as well. Okay, so basically there's a little latch on the side there. You open that. It's a nice little plastic box. I just want you guys to see what's in there. This one I got from Western Bike Works, but you get them out. The link I'll put in there, I think Amazon has the ones with better prices, so I'll put that on there so you guys can see them. But I want to show you what's in the container. And this is another reason why I take it out of the container. It's kind of a pain to get out of there because they've got it wedged in there. I'm having to actually pull it. It got some piece of paper and stuff in there. It's just a pain. So when I'm ready to use it, I put it in my plastic bag, and I'll show you what else I do. So it comes with a little scarring paper there so you can rough up the tube area if you have to patch. But the reason why I go with these is you don't need any glue. A lot of times I take it off like this. See right there? It's sticky. I'm just going to touch it a little bit so I don't mess it up. Right there. So what I do, though, I don't carry them like this. I take my scissors. I take my scissors and I slice these at least one or two in half. And the reason I do that is this is such a large area that when you're roughing up the tube, you have to rough up an area larger than this patch for it to stick. Okay, even if you're using the one with glue, which is like this. This is the one that has glue. I only use these at home because I do patch my tubes. I bring them home and I patch them at home. I don't want to do it on the road. I don't want to wait for glue to dry on the road. So I have these as well, but I use it at home in the shop here. So on the road, I'd much rather if I have more than one flat. And let's say I got one tube and I have a flat more than once, which is super rare. I mean, I have a flat maybe once a year, maybe, if that. It's not very frequent because I will tell you why. I read the road. So I cut at least two of these into smaller pieces and I have that in there. And then the rest of them can be in a regular size just in case you get a larger hole that you have to patch one day. But the reason you want to do the small one is most of the holes you have are very small. You might get a little pinhole and you get a slow leak. And then once you get that sorted out, you don't need a huge patch to seal that. And so it's nice to have half the size and you don't have to go rubbing all over the tube. That's the reason I cut them. Because you rarely have, when the hole is super big, the patch won't hold that well anyway. So that's the reason I cut them. Now, let me put this back in the container here. So what I do is I take it out of that container and I put it in a plastic bag like this. Just a small plastic bag. Okay? And all of these, a few of these are cut and they're nice and small and you carry that with you. That's for situations where you used up your tube and then you end up with another flat. Well, you can always patch. That's a nice little safety thing to have. So because of that being in there, carrying one tube, it's not that big a deal for me because I don't have flats that often. And the reason is because I read the road. When it's wet and I'm riding, I avoid debris. If I do have to go through glass or whatever, I you know, especially when I'm wearing gloves, which most of the time, I put my hand on the tire and let that rub off. Because when it's wet, glass will stick to your tire and work its way in. So if you go through glass on a wet day, you got to clean your tire. Even if you have to stop, spin it, and clean. Because you got to be careful, especially when you're doing the rear. Don't get your hand caught in there. Don't try to look cool. Be careful. If you're trying to rub off the tire, you got to be really careful when you do that. Anyway, I'm getting a little off topic here. So in the little pouch, and the reason why I separate the money and the key and whatever, so it's not just jangling around making noise. So it's nice. So if you're going to do a Ziploc bag, maybe find a smaller bag to hold the loose stuff, like your patch kit and all of that, because you don't want it mixed with everything else. You know, that's why I put the patch kit in its own little plastic bag so I don't lose the glue You don't lose the properties of the glue because they'll be there for a long time. I mean, I might have a flat every 18 months, if that. You know, it's not that often, but you still need to be ready because when you do, it's a big deal. So, essentials, money, ID, some form of ID, your key to your house if you need it, which is a good idea to have because you never know. It's just an extra key I made and it just stays in here permanently. So I always have a key just in case I leave the back door open and somebody at the house is going and they lock it. So you're never locked out because that does happen. You always have a key in there and you have your patch kit in here. Now, as far as changing stuff, I'm going to summarize as I do the reverse of what I did to take things out. You want a tube and you want a tire iron. That assumption is that you have foldable tires. If you have wire bead tires, you need at least two tire irons, minimum, because they're a pain to get off. In fact, I would suggest that you wear out whatever wire bead tires you have and don't buy another one. They're not worth the headache. You get so your one tube and that. You need some way to fill up the tube with air. I use a pump. Some people use canisters and whatever you use. You want to, don't forget it. With this pouch I have, everything's together. When I use this smaller patch on several separate days, I have another pump that's made out of carbon like this. I have to remind myself to take because you don't want to not have your pump. It sucks if you have a tube and everything and you can't air up your tire. You're stuck because the Presta valve is not common out there. Okay? Now, let's see. And then you want some kind of tool just in case. In this pouch, I keep this Lazine multi-tool. It has everything, including a chain tool. But to be honest with you, in the 3 decades I've been using these things, I've never had a need for it. In fact, I end up using it on other people's bikes that have not kept up with their maintenance. Because periodically, I make sure my bottle cages are snug and those little things that can work their way loose. I keep up with those kind of things. So I rarely need this. But it's really just nice to have. But if you can't have this multi-tool at a minimum, have one of these. This is a 4 millimeter. That's the size that holds most of the cleat bolts if you use the 3-bolt systems. I always like to have at a minimum a 4 millimeter. But because I have this in here, I don't carry anything else. This just stays in there. That's why I got it. It's nice and light. And the reason why I'm harping on this, they have other stuff out there. Let me show you. I have them, but I don't carry them. This one here is made by Topeak. I don't carry this because it just feels like a stone. It is just heavy. I don't know how they did it, but the weight is just, I just don't like the way it feels. It's kind of heavy. So I bought it a long time ago. It was pretty inexpensive. And I just found out I don't like to take it with me. The Lazine is much lighter and the weight is distributed differently. It doesn't feel like a stone. It's spread out differently, if you know what I mean. So I prefer the Lazine over this one. So I choose to carry nitrile gloves. Weight is negligible. I fold them up nicely. You can put these in your plastic bag or whatever you have. They're good to have to keep your hands clean. I hate having dirty hands after I work on my bike. And in fact, I've only used these working on other people's bike when I was on group rides that I helped. But they're good to have. And in this pouch, what I do is I stick it in the little side pocket here. So it's out of the way. Then I carry a couple of wipes. I mean, you can carry one, but I carry these just in case if I need to wipe my hands or something. So I just keep these in here. If I'm going to carry this pouch, I might as well use it. And this is in there. So this is what's in my pouch. So I've got my tube, my way of airing up my tires. I've got the gloves to keep my hands clean. I've got wipes to either clean my glasses or whatever comes up on the road. And then I've got a multi-tool. And depending on which wheels I'll use, a lot of times I will carry my spoke wrench. So if I ride the Camp Agnolo Zondas, I carry my spoke wrench with me just in case. I've never had to use it, but you never know. So I don't keep the spoke wrench in here, depending on which wheel I'm using, because I have a different spoke wrench for the Urus, because its nipple is a different size, and I have a different one for the Camp Agnolo Zonda, which uses the standard size. But if you have standard size wheels, just keep a spoke wrench in there, especially if you're going on very long rides. The longer the ride, the more things you want to have in there. You want to be able to, if you broke a spoke, readjust the other ones for those of you who are familiar with working on wheels so you can at least get home. That's the reason for carrying a spoke wrench. And even if you can't do it yourself and you're in a group, somebody else might be able to help you if you have the tool. So those are the things I carry in my bag. And I believe that's the essential for what you need to have out there. There are people that I've read on the forums that carry a lot more. It's not necessary. You don't need three tubes. I mean, what's the point? How often are you really going to have a flat? It's very rare that you have multiple flats. And usually that's because you've left something in the tire. So I will make a video about how to change the tire, what to look for, and that should help you get by. So for the most part, one tube. If I'm going on a long solo ride, I take another tube here and I stick it in my other pocket on a long solo ride because then I don't have to use up my patch if something happened. But for the most part, group ride, this is the pouch I take. My pump, everything is in there. I'm good to go. If you're carrying a different pouch, like sometimes I carry this pouch, which will still hold a tube if I don't put my phone in there. But most of the time I put my phone in there. If my phone is in there and I'm carrying this pouch, I just stick this on the side. Then I have to remember to grab my other Topeak pump because you want to have a way to pump up your tires. It's kind of embarrassing if you're out there, you got everything but air, you know. And most of the gas stations use Schrader valves. There are little adapters that come that you can use at the gas stations. I have one here. I don't really carry it, but it looked like this. The little adapters that you can screw onto your Presta, and at a gas station, you'll be able to get air in there. This is something I've had here for a long time. I have a couple of them. So if that's something that you can have with you, but I really don't carry that because I don't forget to carry my own air. I don't like to depend on gas stations. So that's what I wanted to cover today, just the critical things that you need to have in your patch kit. So right now, I'm only carrying stuff in my jersey in the middle pocket or the side pocket with these bags. I am not putting anything on the bike because I found I was leaning towards the Arundel bag, but it turns out that after a while, even though it was just touching the back of my leg and not on the seat post, it still was rubbing a hole in my shorts, and it's not worth the headache. So I use something small like this if I'm going to strap it on the back on the bike so it's back in the air, back there, up and away from me. But I'm still looking for something that will keep the bag that's under the saddle away from my legs. They have a few out there. Lazine has a few. I'm still researching to see which one will work. But I just wanted to focus more on the contents of what you carry. So you need a tube, a way to air up the tube. Nice to have is a multi-tool. It's not an absolute need because if you're maintaining your bike, chances are you're not. You know, it's nice to have in case something comes loose. But for the most part, if you're keeping up with stuff and you've torqued everything correctly, nothing really, you know, necessitates that need. So, you know, your tube, a way to air the tube. It's nice to have a glue-less patch kit with you just in case you have multiple flats. Then you can repair your tube on the road. But for the most part, that's all you need. You don't need a huge bag. I mean, I've been on rides where there was a guy that had like almost 5 pounds of stuff. I mean, I was like, what the hell you need all this crap for? It was just too much stuff. And I think he just didn't know. You know, there's no reason to carry anything more than a tube and a patch kit. In fact, if I'm going on a very, very fast ride, just short, all I carry is a patch kit, tube, and a pump. I don't need all the other stuff. I don't carry that big bag. I carry this guy, the little one. You know, especially if I'm wearing my thin jerseys, you know. So I'll put the link for this bag out there as well. The Waterfield bag is really good. It's all in one and whole. So leave your comments and questions below and any additions you have. But at a minimum, that's all you need. And I will make a different video about repairing the flat on the road and the things to look out for. And that should clear up how I avoid having flats. I don't get flats very often. It's rare. But it does happen, but it can happen when you least expect it. So I never ride without my repair kit. So I just wanted to cover that today. Okay? So no matter what, don't let anything stop you. Get out there.